Hi friends, Chandrashekhar here again, and this is the seventh in the series of lectures on Vimshottari Dashā. I think we would need one more or two more lectures before we finish off the topic. Finish off means that is always a never ending topic, because there are many interpretations to how Dashas are to be interpreted. I am trying to tell you about how I look at them, and even I, over the times in my life, when I started studying from age 70 to now, 8 to now 73, I also found some different interpretation to the same shloka, and so I apply them. We will talk about it whenever there is any question relevant to that which comes to me. So now we come to the most repugnant to me but most interesting to others, the topic of Marakasthana. What planets are likely to finish off, kill, impart death to a Jataka? I mean, many people are more interested in this part than on saving others. I am more interested in the life part of it and how to face the problems that are bound to arise in any human life, regardless of his status, place of birth, caste of birth or whatever. It doesn't make any difference. And anyway, caste is different from Varna, so don't confuse between the two. And so we will look at what are Marakasthanas. Now, somebody who is only an initiate in the astrology, it would be very obvious the 8th house has to be the Marakasthana. Why? Because it is called house of death by many, though it is actually house of life. When it gets hard, then death occurs, so it is also called the Mrityusthana, as against the actual name of Ayushthana. So, it is obvious that 8th house lord can impart death during his dasha, antar dasha, pratyantar dasha, etc. Whatever is relevant and whenever the necessary transits are also indicative of that. Besides the calculation of age also, I mean the band in which we calculate that this Jataka might not no longer be with us, during that time all these things come together and they will indicate something to us. But there is something more. And what is more? And why is it more? And it will also make one understand how many a times our understanding of Kendra Sthanas are always Shubha or something like that, all those formulas that we go about carrying in our brain as we start learning the initial stages of astrology. Of course, later on everybody understands that there are always exceptions and exceptions to exceptions. Pardon me if I am repeating myself, but I think it is my duty to remind the listeners about principles that we have already discussed. So what are these new places? So it is said Ashtamam Yayushasthanam. 8th bhav is the house of life. That is what I have always been telling. So you can understand it is not Mrityusthana, it is Sthana of Ayush. Ayush is life, the lifespan. And then Ashtamat Ashtamam Chayat. Also, the one which is 8th from this 8th house is also to be known as the Ayushthana. Which is it? 8th from 8th is always the 3rd bhava. So, Tayor Api Vyasthanam. Any planet which is in the 12th to this, or any bhava which is 12th to this, and here we are talking about bhava, Marakasthanam Uchchate. It is called as the Marakasthana. So what would be the Marakasthana? 12 to 8th is 7th and 12 to 3rd is the 2nd bhava. So 2nd bhava and 7th bhava are called as the Marakasthana, the places whose lords can impart death in their own dashas. Whenever we say death, always remember this applies to death, Mahadasha, Antardasha, Pratyantardasha, Sukshma Dasha, Pranadasha, Deha Dasha. And even if you want to split it further, As I always jokingly call it, the Chandra Shakar Dasha. You can always, you know, there is nothing secret about it. No secret. You can always calculate the, you know, the years allotted to a planet by Dasha and the time allotted to the Brahma Dasha, multiply, divide by 120 and then calculate what it comes. So that proportion, in that proportion, the Dasha by proportion multiplied by this, you know, the whatever upper level Dasha you want to further divide, will give you the even more split time or time bands even below the Deha Dasha. So it's not rocket science, it is just an application of a proportion. So kindly understand this. Otherwise people think it's something extremely divine. Nowadays the tendency is to call everything divine. Yeah, knowledge is divine. So anything which connects with knowledge is divine. That is the form of Lord Shiva. That is why he doesn't have any form. That is the pure knowledge. All knowledge is divine. So our attempt to take it to some religious side or something, while laudable, we belittle our sages and their intelligence. So now we can, as we go along this series of lectures, we can understand how great knowledge they had and what was the depth of the knowledge and the understanding, also understanding of mathematics. So we now understand that second Bhava Lord and seventh Bhava Lord are supposed to be the Marakasthanas. So there are two. Who is stronger amongst them? There are different opinions. Some say seventh is stronger, some say, but as far as Sage Parashara and other sages have said, they say second Lord is a more powerful Maraka than the seventh Bhava Lord. Apply your logic to why? Everything must have some reason. Now they have given you the logic, expenditure of life is death. So naturally, the original Ayushthana's 12th Lord and the tertiary or secondary Ayushthana, that is the third house's 12th Lord, would become the Maraka. They would be able to deliver death during their own dashas, etc. So now the question is, why second is more powerful than the seventh? To my mind, that is perhaps because it forms the pair with the eighth house, which is the Ayushthana. So we will, I mean, as you go along, we have already discussed it in many of the Bhava principles and other things. One and seven always form a pair, and death and life are also pair. Now, this is my interpretation. I might be absolutely wrong. It could be the statistical evidence that they had collected over time, which led the sages to say that second Bhava is a more powerful Maraka than the seventh Bhava Lord. Now, we have understood this. Not much of a problem. What happens to the 12th Bhava? Because till now, I mean, at least till we were talking about it, we thought that second Lord is a neutral Lord. The 12th Lord is also a neutral Lord. Isn't it? Now it suddenly turns up, it is not so. In case of death, imparting power, second Lord does have power to impart death. What about the 12th Lord? So, what they say, Tesham Sambhave Sakshat Vaya Yesham Dasham Shvapi. The Lord of the 12th can also impart death. Why? It is 12 to the body, the Lagna itself. Because what dies after all? According to our ancient sciences, the Atma, the soul is, it never dies. It only gets into something else, in some other state, like energy. That is why I always call it energy. Energy which manifests through our body. It is there till our body is alive. Once it is gone, our body is also gone. So, I mean, not going into the religious part of it or the spiritual part of it, you can understand why 12th. Again, the expenditure of something. Expenditure of body, expenditure of lifespan, expenditure of the secondary lifespan. That will all give the ability for those grahas to impart death during their. Now there is another thing. They say tadisha tustatra gataha tada isha. Lords of the second and lord of the seventh, if malefics, and here I would always take both functional and the natural malefics, if they occupy those bhavas or they conjoin the lords of the Marakasthana, the second and the seventh, then in their dashas, antar dashas, they call it tesham dasha vipakashu. Vipaka means the paka is always mahadasha, so vipaka will mean the antar dasha. Sambhavam nidhanam runam. It is possible that people will die, or the jataka, when born, about whose, you know, about whose life we are now calculating, or anyway, all the charts are looked at from that point of view. Then they say, even benefics in those bhavas can give death. Extremely sorry. They say if you sneeze, it is true. So perhaps what I was telling you was right. At least the gods have desired that it is light. It has nothing to do with my knowledge. So benefics in 12th, 2nd, 7th, etc. can also kill. But when will they kill? Not in their own dasha. The dasha of the 8th lord. Lord of the 8th bhava. So if the dasha of lord of 8th bhava is operating and a benefic is placed in 12th or 2nd or 7th, it can also kill. My own interpretation is if he is conjunct those lords, then also that benefic might give results of death to the Jataka during that period. Why? I will try to explain sometime as we go ahead. I speak a lot. I speak sometimes disconnected as I learn from people. And yeah, but that is the way I do it, and that is how I have learned the science, because nothing is disconnected in this great science of astrology. I would not call it divine again and again. It is divine. Knowledge is divine. So, then there is something more. They are told about, the sages have already told us about the very strong planets who are the strongest to impart death. The lord of the Marakasthana, they are always called the Marakesh. One who can kill is Marakesh. Rather, Ish means the lord. So, Marakasthana, lord of the Marakasthana becomes the Marakesh. Whichever way you like it. You can also call him Yama, because Yama is said to be, Lord Yama is the lord of death. Ish is also god or the boss or the owner. So, whichever way you like, whichever way you are inclined, you can take it. But then there is something else. There is one great person who is left out. Who is it? That is the great Saturn. I always call him great because he is a teacher. He is a teacher of the type that we had when we were young. If we committed some mistake, or if we could not remember something which was told to us, we must learn by heart, then the teachers would cane us. But that caning was not with a foot rule or anything. It was with a flat scale which was held vertical. So this edge used to hit. That is what is the duty of Saturn, and that is why people are afraid of it. Remember, Saturn in mythology is said to be the brother of Yama, the lord of death. But what is the Yama? He is also called Dharma. He is the lord of Dharma. Whatever Dharma you do, whatever duties you perform, according to that he will grant you the lifespan and take you away. Same happens with Saturn. Saturn doesn't kill that way, but he would teach you lessons. You better listen to them. If you don't, then you get into problem, and then we say Sade Sati is going on, XYZ is going on, and whatnot and whatnot. But all those things do not actually matter for going ahead in what we have been already discussing. I hope this, you are not getting bored with all those things that I am telling you. I am just trying to tell you How these planets can manifest, what they do, remember that Shani is Karaka for Dukkha, and for you to be Dukkhi, that is, for you to experience sorrow, you have to live. So that is why in astrologers of my generation, we generally say, Shani generally doesn't kill, he will give you trouble. And so going ahead, what has Shani to do with all this? You must be thinking about what this old man is talking about, the great Shani, and this is left out, and what is happening to him? No. Then there is an aphorism. There is a reason why I am telling you. There is an aphorism which says, Marakai Sahi Sambandha Nihanta Papakrut Shani. So, if Saturn comes in contact with Maraka, Marak planet, some also opine Marak Bhava, I would think he has to conjoin or come together with the Marak planet amongst all those we have seen. Then what happened? Atikrametaran. Atikrametaran means Atikram Itaran. He will push apart all other Marakas, the Lord of the 2nd, the Lord of the 12th, the Lord of the 7th, even the Lord of the 8th, and he himself will grant death to the Jataka. So this is very important in a way, because what happens is we generally tend to think rather like to call it monocular vision. We only look through one lens. You need two lenses to actually understand the depth of field and proper the understanding or proper analysis of a chart. This is astrology. We have to take into consideration everything, and this everything includes not only the natal chart, not only the transits, but also Vimshottari chart. They have to operate in conjunction with each other so that we get the whole picture of what is happening in the life of a Jataka at a particular point of time, or what is likely to happen in future in his life. So my friends, I trust I am not boring you and you are getting some knowledge. Rather, I would not say you are getting some knowledge, I would say this is adding to your knowledge of astrology which you already possess. Otherwise you would not be going through all these many lectures and listening to them and then giving me feedback. So this is how we look at the Maraka, the part of death, when a person is going to die. But remember that for that to be correctly said, you will have to understand the lifespan, probable lifespan of the Jataka. And if you ask me, it is better if we don't talk about death of a person, or we don't predict death. At the most, in cases where you think it is very necessary for certain reasons, you can give an indication in a very polite manner that perhaps this period is not very good. If this is over, then this guy will live, or something like that, because you never know that sometimes extremely critical people get well and live again for a long time. So that is not in the hands of the astrologer, neither is astrologer supposed to predict death, at least as far as I understand astrology and the scriptures or whatever I have read. I think it is better if we don't do it, because that death is not only dependent on the chart, also the karmas in the present life. If I remember right, with age sometimes I mix up the sources from which I am telling you, but I think Dhritarashtra asked Vidura as to why, when the sages said that a person has 120 years of life, people die early, or some even exceed it. And he says that this tree of life which is granted to you is certainly 120 years. But with their own actions, people use their actions as axe to cut that life to size. And depending on their karmas, they will leave this place early or late. Karma what? Not only of this Janma, also of the previous Janma, the previous birth. Any of those births, not even immediately previous birth, it could be any of the birth. This karma will visit you sometime and take you away. So, my dear friends, my advice as an elder, if you consider me elder, would be better not to predict death of anybody. Even Parashara says that till age of 24, it is better not to calculate the life of anyone. He first says that about for 12 years of age, till that time the age should not be predicted. But we have to understand what these sages were not in the habit of repeating, as I am repeating. I am no sage, so I repeat things many a times in lectures. You will find me repeating things again and again. But you have to give an old man the chance to be a bit idiosyncratic in this regard. So my friends, thank you for listening to me so patiently. In this recording, there have been many interruptions. See, this was all about death. And even perhaps the God doesn't want you to know more about death. Two or three times there were some calls and then I had to shut it off. And now I am splicing the video. Once, of course, I sneezed. So perhaps at that time, whatever I was telling you was correct. And so my dear friends, you have heard me so patiently. I am so thankful to you. Good night.